I'd never danced before in my life. If you'd told me that dance was going to become a huge part of not just my social life, but my whole life, that it would end up taking me to Buenos Aires for months, I'd have thought you were crazy. If you told me I could invite a woman to dance from the other side of the dance floor, just using eye contact and a nod, that this dance has no fixed steps, no fixed patterns, and yet two people who may not have even met before can dance together in perfect synchronization. I mean, how does that even work?
Anybody can dance. Remember that. It's not about the physical limitations or abilities. It's not about age. It's very beneficial for well-being, for health, for social interactions, for building connections with people. People who dance, they're more resilient to stress, they find it much easier to communicate with others, expressing their feelings and their words. I know many dancers whose day job will be far from anything artistic, but tango helps them to bring out that artistic side and making it something their own, and also to bring their own personality into dance. You're not only focused on your dance partner, on the music and how wonderful it all feels, but you're also very much aware of the other couples around you. But that's why it's called social, because you are among other human beings. For me, every time I go out, I dress up, I have a good mood, and I'm ready to enjoy the night. For me, it's like a little party, to something to celebrate and share with others. Because once it works, you just want to repeat it over and over again.
Number one thing that makes me feel most alive is when I'm dancing with another person and feeling the freedom to co-create and express our feelings together. Seventeen different nationalities amongst 40 different attendees, and you get this blend of their original cultures mixed in with the tango culture. It's just such a happy family, and tango is so much fun because you can go to a place, never having been there before, take your little shoe bag, trot out into the city centre or out in the countryside, and you don't even speak a word of the language, but you can have a great night dancing, because most of the tango culture at a dance event is non-verbal. I don't speak another language, but I do speak tango.
I feel wanted. I feel there is somebody there that appreciates me. You feel cherished, and he's holding you in his arms, and he also escorts you back to your seat. It's the overall experience that you only get in tango. Men find it difficult to express themselves. In tango, they get this opportunity to let go of themselves, that feeling they have that is kept inside them. They are allowed to express themselves through the dance. You feel like you've got wings and you're floating with this guy. There is this feeling of passion, romance. It gives me a sense of identity, able to express myself, leaving all your problems behind. The music, the embrace, talking about it gives me goosebumps. It's just a beautiful feeling.
Tango is very addictive. It's very refreshing for me from my busy work life. And I find a comfort and I find a joy in tango. And I also find a joy in learning and meeting new people.
Thank you.
I made a lot of new friends through tango. I cannot say that I'm not shy anymore, but I'm better at it, and tango really played a big part in that journey. I can get connected with that person, and I can transform that energy of music in that moment, and that's the best feeling.
You feel like you're floating. Gliding across the floor, you feel like you're on Strictly Come Dancing or whatever it is, you know. You just have that moment and it's lovely, and usually if one of you have it, the other one has it, and you kind of like finish your dance, look at each other and go, wow. Just being free and forgetting about the rest of the world, and just close your eyes, and it's just, especially if you get a really good connection with the man that you're dancing with or the lead, it's just the best thing ever. The holding tango or the embracing tango is quite beautiful within itself, without having to do anything else, just going into a close hold, which is like a lovely warm hug, and feeling safe and secure and being guided around the floor is second to none.
I think for me, what gives me the most pleasure is when I'm dancing with a partner, the music is flowing, and we're the only two people in the room, and we enter this almost like trance-like, dream-like state where we, you know, connect, almost like our souls connect. So prior to tango, you know, I was a very introverted person. I'd spend a lot of time in the gym. What I noticed was that I've become a very sociable person. It's quite unlike anything else in any other field, whether it's sport or art or anything else that I've partaken in the previously. And it just keeps me coming back for more.
The music, the movement, how I was moving, I suddenly thought, oh my God, I'm actually dancing. And it was joyous. You are moving together to music, you express yourself obviously physically with the dance and how you are in the embrace, but it's an emotional closeness, I think, that is experienced together, and it's just fabulous. Makes me feel beautiful. I feel myself like somebody, you know, in a romantic film dancing away. It's this closeness of the embrace, being physically close to somebody, moving meaningfully together to beautiful music. It's that high that we chase, and for me, just wanting more of a good thing.
Honestly, the thing I love most about tango is the music. It's just really magical, and all these themes that people wrote about and sang about or just set music to it in the early 20th century is still relevant now. Once you've had an amazing dance with someone, there's this desire to recapture that experience, and it's something ephemeral, is transcendental, but it almost always feels like it's gone in the moment. Where you're dancing with someone and you just feel like you're one. Being able to connect someone on such a deep and intense level, I think. I used to be much more close, I think, to other people, so it did helped me open up, because in tango, where you dance with someone, you're not really speaking to them through the mind, it's more you're just communicating yourself, your soul, your personality, your heart.
It just feels beautiful. I don't know, I feel very beautiful, and it's like you're in love with this person for this song, and the other world just doesn't matter, so it's just the person you're dancing with. Everyone is very welcoming and very friendly, especially when you try to learn the tango. And we always go as a group of people, so that's also a very important factor, I think. You have to find a connection with the new person in a split second or like a few seconds. So I think that kind of helped me to go over and be easier around people that I didn't know before, not just in tango, but also in my day-to-day life. Makes you be in the moment. We don't do that very often, especially not in London, when everyone is just running around, especially like tube, and you just go and that's it. Well, in tango, you actually stop while moving, you flow, and that's your moment.
You're constantly looking. When can I get that next amazing buzz? Just the buzz of this was perfect. You know you can guide your partner around the floor confidently, it gives you that, like, not a macho, but you have a sense of pride, of joy, like, this person trusted me to take him through. You are fulfilled. You're fulfilled. It fulfills your innermost needs for dancing. And everything is in balance. Mind, physical, body, emotion, everything's just working together. Argentine tango is the ultimate thoroughbred of all dances because there's a lot of things at play. You're listening to the music, you're constantly improvising, and you're dancing with the crowd. And everyone's trying to work together to generate that energy. And that's the ultimate goal. I don't know what to call it, but it's the holy grail of dancing. If you get it right, it's bliss.
If I have a headache, I go dance, and it's a kind of magic. It disappears. A mix of a big happiness and mindfulness, meditation, calm. Like if you have taken the best nap in your life. All these healthy habits that you can add to have a happier life, exercise like walking, or physical love demonstrations like hugs, or a better social life, you have all together in tango. This connection with myself and helps me to reduce my anxiety and to be more present. Really, I think that is the most important thing. I can be present. It's a wonderful experience to be able to hug somebody that you even know. So it's an expression of real love to yourself and to each other.
I dance tango because it is the quickest route to the transcendent bar one that I know of, because it makes me very, very happy. I believe it makes other people very, very happy. And it means that I get a chance fully to inhabit my body. Mi triste adiós, sentirás la emoción de mi dolor. I love that I can have a wonderful dance with my husband calls him my tango husband. I can also have a fabulous dance with somebody that I have never met before. And I have also danced with people much older than myself. And I've danced with people who have physical disabilities. You can dance a completely satisfying dance with anyone. I love the way that queer tango challenges some of the norms of tango. I have to say that in the time I've been dancing queer tango, those norms have shifted, and shifted quite fast. The advice that I would give to somebody who is thinking of coming into tango for the first time is do it. You don't know where it will lead you. You don't know which aspects of yourself it will touch on, make you think about, possibly develop. It can push aside a great many ideas that you might have about yourself and about who you are. And actually, it's not only about who you are, but it's about who you might become if you allow yourself to.
Porque mi alma llena brumas de un invierno que hoy...